tonight, the 1-2-1 sixth place Fort Erie Meteors battle the 2-1 fifth place Caledonia Corvairs. Good evening, welcome to the HCCC. I'm John Molson. Tyler Lepore had two goals as the Corvairs got their first win on home ice, beating the previously unbeaten Niagara Falls Canucks 4-3 here last Saturday. Devin Derrick had the only goal, assisted by Alex Huron at the 14:06 mark of the first, in the 3-1 loss to Welland on home ice for the Meteors. The Meteors last in action last Saturday at the Fort Erie Metroplex. Just about set for the opening period, the Fort Erie Meteors, their only win on the season, the 4-3 victory on September the 13th, 2 weeks ago on a Saturday, as we now stand for our national anthem. Fort Erie, as mentioned before the anthem, coming in at 1-2-1. The Corvairs at 2-1 on the year, looking to jump into a four-way tie for second place tonight. Caledonia starting off the season with a 3-2 win in St. Catharines and a 4-3 victory here last Saturday over Niagara Falls. Connor Patton out to take the opening draw. Matt Hoare on the right wing. Opposite Drescher for the Meteors. On his wing, Dalton Tartaglia on the right-hand side. Drescher wins the draw. It comes back to Van Horn. Rockford falls down on the play, and Garland throws it around the far side boards where it's cut off by Ratchford. Into the corner goes Drescher. It comes out to the Caledonia blue line, and Bramwell tries to glove it down at the top of the Fort Erie blue line with his right glove, back in their own zone now. Van Horn tries to clear. It's picked off by Fort Erie, and the pass across to Tartaglia from Drescher. And now in behind the end line on the near corner is the number 22 forward, Holden Garland. Slapping it back in is the number 6 defender, Civlotti, as Matt Hoare falls down at the right-hand side of the blue line, and a face-off to take place out to the right-hand side. Well, now they're moving the draw out to the neutral zone, so out to the right of Brendan Pulasic. Falling in the neutral zone is Jake Brown, played up the boards by Robbins and picked up by Matyi. And a shot to the far side, taken off the shoulder by Pulasic. And automatic icing as Martin goes back to get it. Liam Conway starting in the net for Fort Erie, registering a 1-2-1 loss record, one loss in the shootout, a goals against average of 347 as the draw to take place to the left of Pulasic. The Corvairs win it. Peacock now on the far side board. Robbins looks for a hit, and intercepting is Delkin Conway at the right side of the Caledonia blue line. Robbins from center slaps a long pass in. No one there for Fort Erie as they go on a line change and picked up by Justin Abraham. The pass too far for Jamie Forsland, and the defense of Fort Erie intercepts on the right side. DeMarco into the corner, and Abraham doing a nice job slapping away with a long pass to the far side board underneath the end line. Jake Brown now with it, drops it to the defender. Abraham head up, goes back to the neutral zone, and Lepore with the two goals last Saturday against Niagara Falls picks it up in the neutral zone. Moran from the left side across to the right, and the Caledonia defense clears up the right-hand side where it's intercepted by Hollowell. His long pass too far for the winger on the left side, number 10, Devin Dara. And Caledonia intercepting by their own line. Lepore, the cross-ice pass as McKennedy tries to dump in from center. The second opportunity by McKennedy, a bouncing shot handled by Conway as Cam McConnell, playing his second game for the Corvairs, looks for a rebound on the bouncing puck, but Conway able to make the save, and the faceoff out to his left glove side as it's won by Trublin back to the right side of the blue line. The shot by Fontana may have caught the underneath side of the mask of Conway. A large bang. The original shot up into the head area of Conway as the Meteors now moving the other way. And the shot deflecting off to the right-hand side of McKennedy. McKennedy, a partial block shot as Gomes brings it back to center. Fontana, the drop to Gomes, and this time Fontana moves in behind the Fort Erie net to take the second pass by Gomes. Van Horn off the blue line. Trublin, the short pass to Van Horn as the whistle goes. 3 minutes and 35 seconds into period number one. No score between the 2-1 Caledonia Corvairs and the 1-2-1 Fort Erie Meteors. Fort Erie trying to tie the Corvairs, or excuse me, overtake Caledonia by 1 point in the standings with a win here tonight. And Caledonia trying to move into a second place tie. The Falcons on top of the division with a 4-1 record coming into tonight's action. They're next at home against Fort Erie tomorrow night at the Jack Gatecliff Arena as the whistle sounds. 4 minutes and 1 second into period number one. A faceoff in the neutral zone. Patton opposite Drescher. Patton registering one assist on the year. And he wins the draw back for Rashford around the net, up the far side wall for Hoare, and it's dumped in by Mikhailov, the Fort Erie defender. Bramwell down the left-hand side. Hoare streaking down through center, and Hoare grabs it on the near side board. A big hit by Drescher on the near side as Fort Erie clears down the near board, and Van Horn back to pick up the disc for the Corvairs. The shot off the half wall, handled by Pulasic. Pulisic playing in one game, making the seven saves back in the game against Niagara Falls, the 3-0 loss when Entma was pulled at the halfway point of the second. And Niagara Falls scoring all three goals in the second period of that game. Face off in the neutral zone, Jake Brown to take the draw, and Jacob Bianchi on the left side. Bianchi clearing it in, and this being Bianchi's first game with Caledonia, Forslund tries to clear it up the near wall beside center. It's slapped away by the Fort Erie left winger as Bianchi goes back to make a play on Martin, and now the puck on the opposite side of the defense, and the Fort Erie defender clearing it up to center before it's taken away by Bianchi. And the Caledonia defender Forslund with it back a second time, drops it to Abraham. Abraham around the board, back to Forslund, and Robbins breaks the play up on the right-hand side. The original pass to Brown. Brown with it back now, centering pass, and Peacock trying to make a shot, partially blocked out the right-hand side. Peacock finding himself open for a brief second off the pass from Cam McConnell. Peacock back to the blue line, the shot off the boards. Abraham's shot bounces off the end board, and it goes to the near side. And it's played around the far corner now. DeMarco at the half wall. Bush and DeMarco come together. And the puck coming out the near side at the end line. And Kenny able to clear up the left wing side for Fort Erie. Defender Forslund back for Caledonia. And he clears it up for Bush on the right wing. McConnell Hollowell bodies him out of the play, and the puck squirts in deep to the near side. Brown and DeMarco beside the end line near corner. DeMarco rings it up around the board. It's kept in by McKennedy, and the pass too far for Lepore. And DeMarco back to center, or Devin Dara, excuse me. Caledonia back to center. Gomes making a nice move around the defender. Gomes around Hollowell, but Hollowell back this time on the far side to cover Gomes in the corner. Gomes made the pass back to the right side, and this time Gomes plays it in behind the net before being bowled over by Miss Colsey. Cross ice feed, the Meteors attempting to leave their own zone, and a pass through the neutral zone far side to Natty, picked off by Trublin, and Trublin with a quick wrist shot going cross body from the slot. Trublin shooting to the far side, and the glove saved by Conway. Patton and Drescher on the draw. Drescher wins it. In behind the net is Bramwell and Patton. Patton comes away with it, turns around, shot from the left circle, rebound in the slot. Radford, Bramwell over top the right circle. Some whacking and hacking, and Martin finally able to clear to the sideboard where Fort Erie clears back to center. Drescher back inside the Caledonia line, and Ratchford now backhands it up the wall for Caledonia. Van Horn in behind his own net, up the near side, and the long pass for Van Horn. Van Horn winds up off the outside of the glove of Conway. Bramwell's side of the net. Bramwell calls for it again, goes to the backhand. Bramwell twice there on that shift, looking for an open shot. never did get anything away at the far side. Fort Erie wise to clear it back to the neutral zone. Drescher now into the slot. He shoots, and Pulasic with a save in the midsection. Pulasic keeping it scoreless 51 seconds to the midway point of the first with the save on the far side. And a faceoff out to his right-hand side. Brown opposite Romeo Diantino. Diantino wins the draw out to the left, and Forsland throws his man to the ice along the far sidewall. Forsland takes it away from the Fort Erie forward. Into the corner is Robbins. Civilotti up to Matyi, and Jake Brown with the attempted interception along the far wall. The centering pass for Peacock, and Peacock using his size to move his way around Matyi, but Peacock fanning on the shot, and now on the underneath, Brown in behind the net. And Civilotti plays it to the neutral zone, picked off by the number 97 defender, Austin McKenney. Matyi and Jake Brown from the half wall. Jake Brown plays it back for Forsland, and Forsland missing the pass. McKenney quickly leaving his own zone and slapped away to the neutral zone. Devin Dara, the in behind check by Lepore, and Dara shakes off that check. The centering pass in behind the end line. Caledonia back the other way. McConnell for Bush. McConnell off the interception through the neutral zone. The short pass for Bush at the left hand side. And Wade Kenny drops it back for the other Fort Erie Meteor defender. And this time Richard DeMarco up the far wall. And Ratchford and DeMarco come together. DeMarco back to the right side. And Hollowell missing the pass from his own forward. The Corvairs going off on a full change. The defense of Fort Erie plays the puck back to DeMarco on the left wing. And now the Meteors clear in and go off on a full change of their own. Ratchford through the neutral zone. Natty picked off. Or Natty rather plays it to the far wall on the pickoff. And Gomes finding some room around the near side. And Gomes moving his way around the two Fort Erie defenders on the left near hand side on the way to the Fort Erie net. But Conway making the save on the near post. Gomes from center, taken away by Natty, and Natty's shot flutters wide on the far side and off the glass, just over the top of the board. Fort Erie picks it up in behind the far side, whips it around the boards, picked off by Caledonia, and Gomes plays it back to center. Gomes this time in behind the Fort Erie net, and Conway out to play it. Patton the shot wide, 5 inches off the far side, and Forsland off the blue line to play the disc for Caledonia. Patton and Hoare in the corner alongside Matt Passero and another Fort Erie forward. And Fort Erie picks it up at their own line, clears to center, and the Meteors put out a fresh forward line as Forsland picks it up for the Corvairs. Under 7 to go, first period of play. The Corvairs with a slight edge on the shots on goal. I'd say the Corvairs with a bit of an edge on scoring chances. Pulisic, for the most part, untested, but a couple good saves on the far side earlier in the period. 13 minutes into period number one, no score between the Corvairs and Meteors as the puck deflecting up and out of play off the stick of Bramwell. And the faceoff from the left circle, Fort Erie zone, out to the right stick side of Conway. Drescher wins the draw, but he can't do anything with it. So Hoare moves off the left side of the blue line for the Corvairs and fires a quick shot to the far side. Glove down by Conway. So another faceoff from the same spot. Drescher wins it again. Bramwell in behind the forward lines of Fort Erie to try to make a takeaway. And the Meteors still looking to clear their own zone. And Matyi finally able to do so. Diantino to the far corner along with McKennedy. And Patton, the long clear out for Caledonia. Hoare to the near side. And Hoare clears it around past the end line. Hoare with the initial wrap around out the far corner, but no one up for the Corvairs except for Hoare on that far side. And the Meteors now clear it in from center ice. Diantino clearing it in off the left wing for Fort Erie. Moran and Peacock at the board. Peacock using his size to take it away at the Caledonia blue line. Bianchi beside the Meteor bench, and it's thrown in a long pass off the boards, picked up by Bramwell as Moran goes off on a change following the long pass. Dalkin Conway down the right side for Fort Erie, and he's bodied off the puck by Jake Brown in the near corner. Under five to play now, first period of play. The Arc Pro presentation of the third Caledonia Corvairs home game of the 2014-2015 GOJHL season. And a shot in tight to the net was Christian Natty, and Pulisic may have caught a piece of that one at the near side. Civlotti through the neutral zone for Richard DeMarco. DeMarco plays it in deep down the far side, and Ratchford takes it away for Caledonia. Lepore down the sidewall, moving up on the play is the number six defender, Civlotti. And Bush clears it out to the side wall where the pass too far for Lepore. And it's thrown back up the boards by Civlotti before he goes off on a change. Lepore, the backhand, picked off by Vincent Robbins and back to center for Jake Brown. He loses it, so Abraham plays it up the board, far side. A shot, the quick shot by Abraham and taken off the right shoulder by Conway, the Fort Erie netminder. Mescolzi fires a shot off the glass in behind the Caledonia net. Forsland intercepts to the far wall. McConnell in behind Martin, and Conway plays it around the far board. Abraham plays it around the near side, rings it around the wall and out the near corner, and Bianchi tries a back pass to Fontana and kept in by the number 27 defender, Jamie Forsland for Caledonia. A 3-on-2 developing here for Fort Erie, and a shot along the ice, kicked aside in between the padding by the Caledonia netminder, Pulisic. Caledonia back the other way, and the shot by Trublin, and Gomes trying to tuck in a shot at the near corner. The shot by Alex Huron of Fort Erie, and the Corvairs come right back the other way. Gomes on the left-hand side down by the goal line, And with under 3 minutes to go, Forslund to the box for Caledonia, and Fort Erie to their first power play. Fort Erie at just 3.3% on the power play. And one up from the bottom for the Meteors on the year. Corvairs at 80%, 19th in the league on the penalty kill. The Corvairs win the draw. Bramwell slaps it the length of the ice. And Devin Dara to pick it up for the Meteors, and he plays it down the right wing. The cross ice feed for Martin. D'Antino for Martin, and Martin shoved to the ice by Patton. And a whistle going, the draw back in the neutral zone. A delayed offside on the Meteors. Look for a second there, like the Corvairs might go two men down. Wade Kenny wins the draw, slaps it to the corner. And the Corvairs play it the length of the ice. Picked up by the defender, Bramwell up the left side. But getting the cross ice feed away, Holden Garland goes into the near corner. It's picked off by Moran. The pass for Kenny, but Moran able to pick it off. DeMarco takes it away from him, swats it to the near wall, and the Corvairs clear a bouncing puck out. And the Corvairs make a full change with under two to go in the first. 45 seconds left in the first Fort Erie penalty. Van Horn back for Caledonia. A long pass, but kept in by Fort Erie at the right side by Hollowell. The centering pass for Garland. Garland unable to get to it at the right-hand circle. The shot, Garland in behind the net. Garland with the second opportunity. And then the third chance, Garland actually behind the net, a centering out, and the Corvairs 10 seconds away from returning to full strength. 52.3 seconds remaining in the first. The Arc Pro presentation of Caledonia Corvairs hockey. Fans, be sure to see us on YouTube. All our games from the previous 2.5 seasons, well, 2 and a bit, every home game on YouTube. 2 seasons prior to that, the Golden Eagles playing out of Brantford before the move to Caledonia. Those 2 seasons also on YouTube. So a full library of Caledonia and formerly Brantford Golden Eagles games for you to see. 30 seconds to go now. Bramwell and Patton on the far wall. Pinning the Caledonia forward, Bramwell up against the wall is Alex Huron. And a battle in behind the Fort Erie net out the near side. And the puck back to the neutral zone and cleared right back in by Huron. Moran inside the line and held back up as the buzzer goes. The Corvairs, I'd say, with the better of the scoring chances through period number one, but the Meteors keeping the Corvairs off the score sheet. As mentioned, neither team hitting the score sheet in period number one. And at the end of one, it's the Fort Erie Meteors 0 and the Caledonia Corvairs also at 0. Thank you. The Corvairs out shooting the Meteors 14-6 through one period of play. No scoring on the scoreboard. Caledonia 1-1 at home, a 4-3 win here last Saturday against Niagara Falls. Lepore with two goals in that one. The previous 3-0 loss to the Welland Junior Canadians in the home opener. As the Meteors win the draw, Drescher falling down at center, and Patton throwing a pass to the left wing for Bramwell, and lifting the stick is Matt Hoare now in the near corner. The shot, and the quick shot by Hoare in the right circle, then another hard shot wide by Van Horn on the far side. Hoare, a quick snapshot to the right-hand side, and Conway making the save high on the shoulder. Backhanded in by Garland, Van Horn around the near side. Hoare, Tortaglia, Patton, and Civilotti on the board. Now McEnany in there as well. Cleared down the near side while where Bramwell stops at the half wall. The windup by Forsland and fired wide over the net, and the disc comes out the near side. Peacock, Diantino chasing him, and Peacock plays it up to center for Bianchi. The pass back to center, no one there, so Abraham jams it back up the wall, where it's intercepted by Fort Erie's Martin. And the Corvairs take it away on the far wall, drop it back to their defense, and Forsland plays it back to the neutral zone. Brown from center, streaking down the left-hand side. Peabody in behind the Fort Erie net, the turnaround for Brown, back left side of the blue line, the shot by Forsland, wide of the net, just high of the top corner, far side, and Peacock backhands it in down the near wall, and back down the far side is the defender Civilotti. Jake Brown there as well for Caledonia. Peacock hits his man on the near half wall. And Duncan Conway shakes that off. Conway was going to go on a line change, but the puck going deep into the Fort Erie zone on the far side. And for the puck to evade the stick of Moran, Conway had to change his mind and get back on the play rather than changing. And the Meteors now making that change as the draw from the right-hand side. Caledonia wins it. Ratchford brings it quickly back through the neutral zone. And Conway plays it halfway around the wall near side. McConnell and Jake Brown on the near side board back to neutral territory where it's cleared in by Ratchford. Conway out to play it for the Meteors. The defenseman for the Meteors mishandling, Bush taking it away from him. McConnell to the left side of the blue line, in for Bush behind the end line. Kenny hits his man in the corner. Lepore trying to shake off the check of Kenny, and the Corvairs able to keep it in deep, and the shot by Ratchford, and traffic in front of the net. Lepore and McConnell heading straight to the net. McConnell a little off to the right of Lepore, and Lepore with a nice opportunity off the right hand shot off the blue line, or right hand side of the blue line rather. McEnany winds up and his shot catches the left pad of Conway. Fontana and the defender Martin. Fontana spins him around, gives the short pass to Gomes, and Gomes trying to shake off the check of Alex Urin. Backhanded around the wall, in behind the net. Fontana for Gomes. Fontana calling for the back pass. And now Trublin unable to make a play off the near corner. And it's cleared the length of the ice by Alex Huron, the Fort Erie forward. Huron stays on the ice for Fort Erie. And Christian Natty, Matt Passero, and Martin back for Fort Erie, and he clears it out and around the board far side. Natty back to the neutral zone. Trublin with a backhand pass inside the zone, back to the defender, McEnany. And the quick shot by Trublin. And Conway caught a piece of that before the defender cleared it to the sidewall. And a long clear in by Van Horn. And Conway directs it to the corner. And Trublin with his third shot on the shift from the right-hand side. 15:38 to go. Second period of play. No scoring between the Corvairs and the Fort Erie Meteors. Caledonia out shooting the Meteors on the shots on goal clock in period number one, 14-6. And Abraham directs it to the side wall with a right hand beside the Caledonia bench. And the puck just out of play. A face-off back in the neutral zone. Hoare on the right wing steps around his man and clears back to the defender Abraham. Forslund slaps it to neutral ice. Garland tries to make his way up the right-hand boards for the Meteors. Hoare now in the corner. His shot along the ice hit the near side of the Fort Erie net. And Hoare this time on the opposite side clears it up and around the boards. Hoare heads to the slot on the return feed from Patton. Patton off the half wall near side beside the right circle looking for Hoare, and Hoare's shot wide to the far side. Forslund wraps it around the boards and picked up in the neutral ice by Bramwell. Hoare through center. He tries to use the defender as a screen. Hoare tried to use Josh McAuliffe as a screen, but McAuliffe getting his feet in front of the shot. And now Abraham getting his hands up on Holden Garland inside the left circle Fort Erie zone. And Abraham back to the bench. And some discussion from the Fort Erie coaching staff to the head referee. 2 minutes to Forslund showing on the play. It looked like Abraham with his arms up inside that far left circle. Fort Erie to the penalty box. I got the hands to the face by Abraham, a penalty on Abraham. Perhaps that's what the coaching staff was yelling about. And he caught back to the blue line for McEnany. Josh McAuliffe off for slashing. So obviously an infraction before the hands to the face by Abraham. 1:16 to go in the penalty to McAuliffe. And Brown around the net, far side, gathering speed, the pass to Brown. The shot, and they score! It's immediately waved off. Jake Brown streaking to the net off the return feed from Jacob Bush. Originally, I called Brown from Brown down that right side. That obviously making no sense. Bush on the right-hand side, the ahead feed for Jake Brown. And Brown looked to have the Caledonia first goal, but the net knocked off at the near side. Jake Brown crashing to the net, and no goal. 45 seconds remaining in the Caledonia power play. McEnany, the shot. Patton's side of the net. McEnany down the wall for Hoare. Hoare beside the left circle. McEnany, Hoare winds up, and the shot. And Conway with a save, and Patton there looking for a rebound at the end line. McEnany winds up again, and a big glove save by Conway. McEnany with the hard shot off the top of the blue line, looking to pick the top corner. 8 seconds remaining in the slash to McAuliffe now. Trublin in the draw, and he loses it to Drescher. Drescher plays it down the left wing for Hollowell. And Fontana able to take it away in the near corner beside the end line. Gomes the turnaround. McEnany in behind the end line, gets it back, and the shot just wide by McEnany. Picked up by Fontana. The shot by Forslund. The rebound in front. Trublin trying to tip it in at the far side along the ice. And still no score between the Fort Erie Meteors and Caledonia Corvairs as the Meteors get back to full strength. And the save by Conway. Conway coming out to the top of his crease on the far side to protect the disc. And a face-off out to his right. Bush and Drescher. Drescher forces it off to the left wing. And Lepore works his way underneath the winger. The rebound, Bush inside the left circle. Moran plays it in behind the Fort Erie net. Centering pass. McConnell with the centering pass, this time off the near side. And Moran back to play it for the Corvairs. Drescher's side of the net. The backhand pass by Drescher, looking for Garland. And Tartaglia shoots it back in. A deep pass down the far wall for the Meteors. Lepore around the near side. And McConnell plays it up to the top of the blue line. Lepore heading towards the net. McConnell, Jake Brown down the left wing. So Lepore set it up, going out of his own zone. And the pass down the far wall, and the Corvairs heading straight to the net. 43 seconds to the midway point of the game. Lepore backhands it up the wall. McAuliffe down the right wing. And play broken up by Abraham, who looks ahead. And once again, it's intercepted by Martin. Tartaglia has his stick lifted in behind by Lepore. And Bianchi at the far wall. Hollowell ties him up underneath the end line far side. Jake Brown underneath the near side corner end line. And we've now hit the midway point of the game with no score in the third home game of the year for the Corvairs. Centering pass off the near corner. Jake Brown looking for Bianchi. Bianchi plays it back to the near corner. Peacock's side of the net, and the turnaround shot deflected wide by Brown. Jake Brown, two nice chances there. So the number seven forward, Peacock, using his size to create space for Jake Brown at the far side. This time Peacock works his way into the slot, and the shot sails wide off the stick of Van Horn. Van Horn having to get back in a hurry for Caledonia. Fort Erie right back the other way down the left wing. The shot in tight to the net by Matty. And Palacic getting a piece of that. The whistle going, the puck cleared the other way with 9:03 to go. And a faceoff inside the left circle, Caledonia zone. The Meteors win it. DeMarco back to the right side of the defense. And Paolo Civilotti plays it out past the end line at the far corner. Bianchi intercepting up at center. And backhanded, or an attempted backhand by Van Horn. Stick lifted, Kenny to the net. Three players for Fort Erie charged to the net. Devin Dara, Richard DeMarco, and Wade Kenny for the Meteors. The Caledonia defenseman had his stick lifted. A quick shot there by Kenny on the near side along the ice. And the whistle going with 8:21 remaining in the second period of play. Fort Erie next in action tomorrow night in St. Catharines. St. Catharines leading the Golden Horseshoe Conference with a 4-1 record. Caledonia looking to find themselves in a three-way tie for second with a win tonight. And Fort Erie trying to jump past the Corvairs for fifth. If they can squeak out a victory, still scoreless with 8:15 to go in period number two. Moran at the near wall, can't do anything with it, plays it around for Ratchford, the Caledonia defender. Patton chopped down in behind the play on the long pass down the near side board beside the Caledonia bench. Patton had his feet taken out from underneath him. And Miskolczy to the box. Dakota Miskolczy taking the feet out from underneath Connor Patton after the long pass down the near side. And Miskolczy to sit for 2 minutes. The Corvairs, their first power play on the evening at 9.1% on the year. So just 6% higher than the Fort Erie power play, but the Corvairs looking to get on the board first as Brown drops a short pass for Peacock. Van Horn backhands it to the half wall. Bush in behind the end line. Bush the quick backhand. And Conway with a glove save. Bush charging toward the net at the near side. And a quick backhand flip shot by Bush. Jacob Bush with the shot at the near side. And the faceoff out to the left glove side of Conway. Caledonia wins the draw, and Van Horn off the one faceoff by Brown. And Van Horn with a quick shot hard along the ice, and Conway out to challenge at the top of the crease. 1:20 to go, and another shot by Van Horn. Van Horn with the identical shot before the previous whistle. Peacock on the left wing. Brown wins the draw. Peacock chases after it, but the Meteors able to clear. McEnany back for the Corvairs. The short pass to Brown. Brown picking up speed now and catches McAuliffe in the right-hand side of the neck with a high stick. And Jake Brown to sit down for 2 minutes. They'll play 4-on-4 for 56 seconds. Jake Brown with the high stick into the neck of Josh McAuliffe. So Fort Erie will go to the power play for a minute four, following the 4-on-4 for the next 50 seconds. Forsland tries to jump a check, and it's taken away by Mac Passero, and Passero fires a shot wide on the shorthanded opportunity for Fort Erie. Passero, the possible 2-on-1, taking the shot himself. Caledonia now back to the power play. Forsland to the half wall, the shot, Lepore along the ice, Gomes. Gomes tries to gather in the rebound along the end line off the initial shot by Tyler Lepore. Lepore with two goals in the last game at the 3-minute mark of the first, and at 8:37 unassisted in the third period. The 4-3 victory over Niagara Falls. Abraham, the pass into the slot. Forsland, the return feed off the corner from Fontana. Fontana passed the end line near side, shoveled it out for Forsland. And the shot wide by Forsland as the net knocked off the mooring. A face-off out to the left side of the Fort Erie goalkeeper, Conway. Trublin to take the draw, Forsland in behind him, and Fontana on the left wing. The Corvairs win the draw, Forsland plays it in deep. Fontana skates out the far side, stops at the half wall, Conway back on. The shot, Conway taking a penalty here. The knocking off of the net causing a delay of game, and now back to 4-on-4 hockey, so the delay of game negating the 1-0-4 possible power play that the Meteors would have had. Forsland underneath the end line, back to the point. Abraham winds up, and the deflection by Trublin. Trublin tries to jump the shot, and the shot off the blue line deflected in his feet. He tried to direct the puck in on the jump. Trublin jumped the shot, so I don't think, had it went off his feet, that he would have been called for directing the shot. It was simply a shot off the point, and Trublin trying to jump it, the shot deflecting wide of the net, and Patton taking the draw at the left circle opposite Dalkin Conway. Conway falling down. The interception, Patton here toward the net is Bush. Hoare in the slot, falls over top the Fort Erie center iceman, and the shot off the back of the boards by Riley Van Horn. Hoare head up around Martin. The clear in comes right back to Martin. Hoare failed on the pass, but it came right back to him. Van Horn across the shot, and McEnany hits the outside of the post with 19 seconds to go in the Caledonia power play. The faceoff to come outside the line. Patton opposite the assistant captain, Mac Passero. Passero forces the puck ahead on the draw. And Wade Kenny battled off the puck by McEnany. 2-on-2, Patton to the left side. Gomes winds up and fires wide to the far side. Gomes staying on the right-hand side, inside the right circle. The return pass, Gomes looking for a second opportunity after firing wide far side on the first chance. Van Horn rings it around the board. Gomes, play broken up. McAuliffe plays it down the near wall. Palacic out for the Corvairs, and Van Horn plays it back up the far wall and chipped out by Patton. Tartaglia back deep for Fort Erie. McEnany up the far wall, intercepted by Peacock. Peacock plays it in behind Martin and bowls the defenseman into the boards out beyond the end line far corner. Wrapped up and around the board, but not out. Ratchford able to keep it in for the Corvairs. Miss Colsey here trying to move around Ratchford, but Ratchford bodies him off the puck and plays it up beside the bench to Peacock at the Fort Erie bench. And the whistle goes as the Corvairs play the puck down the right side. 2:39 to go, second period of play. Tristan Drescher to the box, 2 minutes for slashing. So the Corvairs once again looking for the first goal of the game. The Corvairs with the edge on the shots on goal clock through two periods of play. Neither team able to hit the score sheet. Forslund to Gomes, the shot along the ice, and Lepore tries to tip it in the near corner, and it's shoveled aside by Conway. Patton back to the point, Abraham up the wall for Lepore and in behind the end line. Lepore back to the blue line, the fake windup, and Abraham instead plays it to Forslund, who whistles it wide off the far side. Shot by Forslund, blocked by Huron, and backhanded up and out by the Fort Erie defender on the right-hand side. And he backs up now as it's played cross ice for Patton. Gomes to Patton, and Patton fires wide and out the far corner. Lepore at the end line. Short pass further in behind the net, back to Lepore. Abraham played it to Lepore, and Lepore wound up and fired a hard shot into the left pad of Conway. 44 seconds to go, Caledonia power play. Gomes winds up the shot off the right pad. Lepore heads to the net. Gomes the shot off the right pad of Conway. And Lepore trying to tuck it in the near side. 34 seconds remaining in the penalty to Tristan Drescher. 1:13 remaining in period number two. The Arc Pro presentation of Caledonia Corvairs hockey. The Corvairs at 2-1 on the year in the fifth spot in the Golden Horseshoe Conference. And the Meteors able to clear. And back for the Corvairs is McEnany. McEnany through center. Poor at the left circle, or beside it rather, and he slides a shot in. And it's kicked away by the bottom of the right pad of Conway. Winding up, Van Horn, Hoare in front of the net. Scramble, Brown there as well. Brown and Hoare on the shot off the left side of the blue line. Jake Brown and Matt Hoare head straight to the net, and they try to poke away at the top of the circle. Fort Erie able to get back to full strength as Conway somehow hangs on along the top of his crease. Conway with a .904 save percentage going into tonight. He's had to be sharp tonight as he's faced the majority of the shots on goal. The Caledonia goaltender Palacic the not busier of the two goaltenders. Here's a shot by Fontana, the rebound coming right back to him. And the whistle goes as the net knocked off once again. And Trublin frustrated as he was wide open in the slot, the shot from the far side. And the Conway given an earlier penalty for knocking the net off at the near corner. And it looked to be almost the same on this instance as Moran fires wide of the net and off the glass on the far side. And Moran mishandles, it's cleared the length of the ice by Devin Dara. Under 10 seconds to go now, second period of play. So perhaps one or two last opportunities for Caledonia, but they lose the draw to Dara, and it's wrapped around the board. Caledonia gets it back in the corner. Trublin intercepted at the near side, unable to get one last pass across, and the whistle goes with Trublin the last to touch it on the near side. The Corvairs with the edge on the shots on goal clock, but so far after two, no one hits the score sheet. At the end of two periods of play, it's the Fort Erie Meteors and the Caledonia Corvairs all tied up at zero.
Upcoming Corvair action on Saturday. The Corvairs will be in Ancaster for a 7:30 tilt. On Wednesday, the Corvairs will be in Thorold. Game time in Thorold is 7:07. Next moment, you adults have a chance to win. Chuck a puck. And we'll be able to count the pucks as they go out there on the ice.
The Corvairs really firing the rubber at the Meteors through two periods of play, outshooting Fort Erie 16-2 in the second period for a two-period total of 30-8. So the Corvairs looking to use that momentum going into the third period to actually get on the score sheet. On the out-of-town board, the Leamington Flyers on top of the London Nationals, 3-1 with 18 minutes to go in the third. No score yet registered between Lambton Shores and the Sarnia Legionnaires. Brown out to take the opening draw of the third. Drescher opposite him to take the faceoff. Bush on the left wing on the one draw, drops it for the defender, Van Horn to the other side. And McEnany around the board for Van Horn, broken up at the left side of the blue line by Paolo Civlotti. And Peacock falling to his knees. Tartaglia, a short pass to Garland at the left side of the wall. Garland makes his way out in front of the net. Tartaglia from out behind the end line for Holden Garland. And Garland shot wide on the near corner. The whistle going 36 seconds into period number three. A face-off out to the right stick side of Pulasic. Pulasic perfect on the year, making, well, there's the first shot of the period by the Meteors, so their ninth shot tonight. The seven saves in the part game for Pulasic against Welland. So a short sample size for Brendan Pulasic, but a perfect record on save percentage so far. Brown the quick shot inside the left circle, and Conway down to his knees to make the save. The draw from the left circle. Patton feeds it ahead. The short pass to Hoare. Hoare rings it around the board for Bramwell. Patton gets there first. Abraham fires a shot. And Conway getting the right shoulder, or elbow in front of it, excuse me. The shot by Abraham off the right side, it went through traffic. Conway looked like he got a piece of it at the last second, so Liam Conway may not have seen all of the puck, but that last second flinch by the right elbow, and Conway able to make the save. The faceoff in the neutral zone. DeMarco plays it ahead at the blue line. He's unable to get it in, but Wade Kenny playing it the rest of the way. And the long shot from the left side of the blue line. And speeding beside the Caledonia bench is Patton. His feed back to the right-hand side. Hoare there. Now Bramwell and Hoare in the neutral zone. And Devin Dara able to break up play off the right wing. He gathers it in at the far corner in beyond the end line. He centers, no one there for Fort Erie. And the disc back to the neutral zone as the left defender, Josh McCullough, back for Fort Erie, fires a shot along the ice, down three lines, and Pulasic the save on the near side. 2:02 into period number three. The Corvairs with the triple shots on goal advantage. And Conway coming up huge on occasion in this game. Pulasic sharp as well, but Pulasic the less tested of the two as he takes one high off the right shoulder. And Caledonia comes right back the other way on the 3-on-2. Civlotti, Bianchi tries to check him on the near corner. And the pass cross ice by Moran. McConnell back for the Corvairs, and the Meteors play it down deep off the left wing. Civlotti the shot, the elbow save by Palasek. The Corvairs clear it down three lines. Here's McConnell, 3, 4, 5 right hands, and McConnell making quick work in the scrap on the blue line. Cam McConnell giving Miss Colsey 7 or 8 right hands. And Cam McConnell, the ex-Hamilton Red Wing, just pounds Miss Colsey, and Miss Colsey to be out 5 minutes for fighting as well. But McConnell with the obvious upper hand in the brawl inside the Fort Erie blue line. McConnell landing 7 or 8 bombs with the right hand, and McColsey not even a punch in for Fort Erie. That the first fight on home ice of the year for the Corvairs. So the first fighting major through 3 games on HCCC ice. Face off at about the same spot where the brawl took place. The Corvairs win the draw. Trublin plays it down the far side. Civlotti picks it up, or picks it off rather, and goes up the board for Tartaglia. And Fort Erie regroups and plays the puck in deep down the right side. Van Horn up and around the board. Trublin knocked heavily into the bench by Garland beside the Fort Erie bench. Trublin into the corner alongside the Fort Erie winger, or centerman, Drescher rather. And Drescher now tries to play it at the far half wall. He scoops it in deep, and back for Caledonia is the defender Van Horn. Van Horn with speed in behind the Fort Erie net. Gomes turns around. Trublin plays it back to the right side of the line. The shot, and batted out of midair by the Fort Erie defender Martin. Here's a shot, the quick shot by Fontana. McEnany with the shot on net. And the shot by McEnany looked to be going in. And Martin, the defender, swatted it out of midair and out to the near side board. Martin now back once again for Fort Erie. He carries it through the neutral zone. And a quick snapshot over the left side of the line. And Palasek making a save in the midsection at the near corner. So an important shift by Bryce Martin. First the bat down of McEnany's shot off the left side, or the right side of the blue line rather, and then Martin coming back the other way with a hard shot to the near corner, and Palasek making the save. The faceoff out to his right, Fort Erie wins the draw. 4 minutes and 45 seconds into period number 3. Abraham, the high arcing pass back to neutral ice, 2-on-2. And into the corner is Peacock and Bush. Peacock behind the net, centering pass for Brown. Abraham to the left side to Forsland, in behind the back of Peacock. Peacock shakes off the check, in behind the end line. and broken up by the number 17 forward of the Meteors, or number 13 rather, Riley Hollowell. The turnaround shot there by Jake Brown. Brown looking to tuck it in the near side. Brown, the backhand pass for Bush. Excuse me, earlier I mentioned Riley Hollowell as a forward. Hollowell back on defense, and Hollowell this time backing up as Peacock moves in offside at the right-hand side of the Fort Erie blue line. Jake Brown off for 2 minutes for the Corvairs. 14:04 remaining. A scoreless game between Caledonia and Fort Erie. The next home game for Caledonia, not till next Saturday. Caledonia playing Saturday night in Ancaster at the Morgan Firestone Arena. And in Thorold next Wednesday, December, what am I saying? Wednesday, October the 1st, 7:07 in Thorold. Jake Brown off for slashing. And Dara moves around the check of the Caledonia defender, Moran. And he's run over this time at the far side by Ratchford. So after Dara moved off the check of Moran, he was bowled over at the next opportunity by the hulking defenseman, Ratchford, on the far side. Kenny through center, moving around Patton, and slightly bodied off the puck by McEnany. And it's cleared out by Fontana. Van Horn back for Caledonia. The short pass to Fontana. Fontana able to clear, and Fort Erie right back to center ice, this time playing it through the neutral zone on the far corner. Civilotti backhands it in, played up the wall by McEnany. And Hollowell back for Fort Erie. He plays it to Civlotti. Civlotti beside the bench through center. D'Antino shoots it in. It hops off the board far side, where it's picked up by Van Horn and clanked off the glass far side and out. And Civlotti trying to break it up as Trublin. Trublin, an aggressive forecheck on the Fort Erie defender. Civlotti able to stay back long enough to keep it away from Trublin, but this time Lepore on the far side, back checking, and Fort Erie able to get back to center. Lepore up to Matt Hoare, broken up by Hollowell, and back to the Caledonia blue line, where Abraham plays it across for Forsland. Forsland, the deep pass beside the Meteor bench, and the puck out of play with 11:40 to go in the third. An Arco presentation of Caledonia Corvairs hockey. See all our games on YouTube, well, the home portion anyway. And you can next see the Corvairs on the road Saturday night in Ancaster, 7:30 p.m. Forsland back for Caledonia, trying to lift the stick as the Fort Erie forward. And Caledonia Golems able to move it ahead beside the Caledonia bench. Golems moving it ahead down the left side. Hoare and Golems in for Caledonia. DeMarco at the half wall. Plays broken up by Huron. Abraham down deep for Hoare. And around the near side board, the shot! The shot by Forsland. Jake Brown's side of the net, trying to tip in a rebound. And 45 seconds to the midway point, the deciding factor in this game. This game gonna go down to the last 10 minutes before we see a goal. And we could still see the possibility of overtime or a shootout. The shot wide and in behind the net by Brown. And Tartaglia brings it the other way, heads to the net, and the pass off the left circle broken up by Gomes, and Gomes offside as Ratchford and Jake Brown move too far ahead of him on the right hand side. Face off neutral zone. The Meteors win the draw. And it's played in by Moran. Hollowell for the other defender. Brown underneath the right circle, tries a centering pass. It's broken up. Brown to the corner. Two pairs aside in the near corner. Tartaglia shakes off a body. Brown the return feed. And Brown plays it to Moran. The shot deflected up and over the net by Jacob Bush. The long feed as Fort Erie leaves the zone down the far side. The pass through center and the big body check by Tartaglia through neutral ice. Tartaglia stood up a Corvair in between the red line and the Caledonia blue line. The referee with his left arm up, and we'll see if a penalty results here with 9:22 remaining. Kenny in to take the draw. Richard DeMarco on the right wing. Patton to take it for Caledonia. Jake Brown on the right hand side. Shot to the net, and Moran mishandles. And Kenny in front of the net tried to tap it in the far side. Now the turnaround shot off the right hand side. Dara looking for Kenny. And broken up and cleared down the left side. Bush the pass ahead and the automatic icing on the near corner. Caledonia looking for home win number two on the season. Win number three overall, and a win tonight would put them in a four-way tie for second with 6 points. Peacock moving around Martin. Peacock in behind the net, and a nice play by Civilotti, the much smaller of the two men, as Peacock centers a pass. And Dara bodied off the puck by Van Horn and back for the Corvairs as McEnany. Civilotti through the neutral zone. Patton picks it off momentarily. And McEnany loses possession and the Meteors shoot it back in from center down the near side. Gomes and Civilotti in the near corner. DeMarco ties up his man, and it's cleared to center by Patton to Gomes. Gomes shoulders off his man and sends McCullough flying into the near board beside the Fort Erie bench. Gomes underneath the left circle fires a shot wide. Trublin to the far side, loses it at the half wall. Fort Erie tries to clear. McEnany, the hard shot along the ice. Glove down by Trublin. And McEnany trying to keep it onside, tries to glove it down with the right glove. And the puck out of play, 7:25 remaining. Face off in the neutral zone. Trublin losing the draw to the number 15 forward Conway, Dalkin Conway. In behind the net, The Corvairs Trublin shovels to the sidewall and moving up on the play is Abraham. Abraham moves off the right side of the blue line to pin it in deep, and the shot high and off the glass by Hoare. Trublin, the short pass out to Bramwell, and the shot high and off the glass by Abraham. Matyai can't clear it out the near side. Forsland to the far corner for Abraham. Back to the half wall for Bramwell. And the turnaround, and in front, Trublin trying to deflect wide to the near side. Abraham, the shot, Trublin in front, and Conway gloving it down on the far side. Abraham with the long shot rising from the outside. Brown losing the draw, the shot into the slot. Brown back to Moran. Moran the turnaround. Martin looking at it as the puck sails to the far wall. Brown goes after it. Martin picks it up, rings it around the wall, and Moran a desperate lunge for Caledonia, trying to keep it onside at the left corner. And the Meteors finally able to clear. Mac Passero throwing at the length of the ice from inside his own line at the half wall. The whistle going, 5:51 to go. Jake Brown on the draw. Peacock to his left. Brown wins the draw. Abraham fires a shot off the right pad of Conway. Moran then sails a shot, this time wide on the far side, and backhanded up and out by the Meteors' Passero. Martin, the cross ice feed for the other defender. And the cross ice feed by McAuliffe, this time down the near corner, going for icing down three lines. Patton and Huron on the draw. Huron wins the draw, can't get it out. Corvairs keeping it in at the half wall. And Mac Passero clears it out with a jam pass, fluttering off the far board. Fontana tries to speed his way around Martin, and he's bodied off the puck at the far side as Gomes tries to play it out. Tartaglia tries to break it up. Passero at the red line as well. And Fontana with numbers on the right-hand side. Patton the shot. So Fontana had Patton open, and Patton firing a shot wide at the far side. Under five to go. Van Hoare back for Caledonia. Loses it, the shot, and it may have caught a piece of the side bar. Garland at the near side, the giveaway by Van Hoare, the Caledonia defender, and Holden Garland trying to capitalize, finding himself all alone at the near corner. McEnany tied up with his man. Trublin with a Fort Erie forward as well. Clanked off the wall by the Fort Erie defense. McEnany plays it deep down the far wall. The defender on the far side plays it up for Tartaglia at the Caledonia bench. And the puck going out of play beside the Fort Erie bench. 3:29 to play, third period of play. A scoreless tie between the Corvairs and Meteors. Liam Conway, the busier of the two netminders this evening. Conway, very sharp for Fort Erie in this scoreless draw. Dara DeMarco streaking through center. The back pass broken up. Here comes Trublin. Trublin to the goal. The shot and no goal. Trublin very close to the first goal. Tried to tuck it in along the ice. That was awfully close to going in, but Conway right on the goal line. The shot by Anton Trublin, tight to the net. And Trublin almost getting it across the line. Trublin moves it forward before being moved off the puck by Wade Kenny. And the whistle going, a hold coming up to Jamie Forsland. So a costly penalty to the Caledonia Corvairs with under three to go. A hold on the near side board beside the Caledonia bench by Forsland. And the Meteors to their first power play of their third period. I believe two penalties aside for each club. Bush clears it up now. A quick pass out by Bush down the far wall. And D'Antino with speed knocked off the puck. Three men back for the Corvairs. And Bramwell able to clear it up and out down the near corner. McAuliffe drops it back for the defender. And the Fort Erie defense sets up to leave their own zone with 1:20 remaining. Bramwell gets the puck. The right defender coughing up the puck. And Bramwell heading to the net and the shot wide along the ice. Dalkin Conway with a shot wide of the net. Robbins off the right side, his shot wide to the near corner. And Abraham jams it up and out down the far side. The quick turnaround up for Dalkin Conway. And he loses his skate, and Van Horn clears it down the near side for Caledonia. Forsland in the box for another 30 seconds, the long clear in. Hollowell winds up the shot, and they score. Hollowell the shot, Richard DeMarco tips it in at the near side. DeMarco finding just enough room at the near corner to break himself free off the right point shot. And Richard DeMarco breaks the tie. And the Meteors ahead 1-0 with just 1:12 remaining. So Pulisic and Conway with shutouts. 18 minutes and 45 seconds to the end of the game. Richard DeMarco, the only goal of the game, perhaps the only one they would need or will need. Sideboard. Dara and Hollowell, so Devin Dara getting a piece of the puck on the way to the net. Hollowell with the initial shot and tipped in by Richard DeMarco with 1:12 remaining in the third. The net now empty for Caledonia. The shot wide, a centering pass. At the half wall, the Meteors looking to turn around and make a play. Brown the drop pass to McKennedy. One last chance for Caledonia. 10 seconds to go. Brown wraps it down the board. In behind the net. Peacock the turnaround. McKennedy side of the net. Matt Hoare tries to bat it down at the far side, but the Meteors hang on in the final seconds. Fort Erie with the 1-0 victory on the Richard DeMarco goal, the deflection off the right point shot, and the Meteors in full celebration as they hang on for the 1-0 lead. So the Corvairs with the huge shots on goal advantage, but the Meteors with the only tally on the scoreboard that counted, the Richard DeMarco goal with 1:12 remaining. For the Caledonia Corvairs Hockey Club, I'm John Molson. Once again, your final score tonight from the HCCC, the Fort Erie Meteors able to hang on and shut out the Caledonia Corvairs by a score of 1-0 on the Richard DeMarco deflection with 1:12 remaining. The Corvairs next in action in Ancaster, 7:30 p.m. Saturday night at the Morgan Firestone Arena in Thorold next Wednesday, 7:07 for a game against the Thorold Blackhawks. Join us for our next home game. That's Saturday, October the 4th, versus the St. Catharines Falcons. Once again, your final score from Caledonia, it was the Fort Erie Meteors 1 and the Caledonia Corvairs no score. The Meteors jumping past the Corvairs in the standings for fifth. The Meteors now 1 point ahead of Caledonia, and the Corvairs next in action at home next Saturday. Be sure to see that game on YouTube. In the meantime, get out to our two away games in Ancaster Saturday, in Thorold Wednesday. Fort Erie 1, Caledonia no score tonight from the HCCC. Good night from Caledonia. See you October the 4th versus the St. Catharines Falcons.